Dr. Siddhalinga Swami, who is consultant at Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital, Hyderabad. In fact, he worked more than 3 years with me, and he is heading the my second hospital at BHEL. And over there, he has done more than 400 to 500 RIRS surgeries. I'm happy that he is also training faculty at Euromed program, one of the faculty member for VLD, and best paper award in our state conference, and published some articles also at this age. Over to Swami.
At the outset, I would like to thank my mentor, Dr. Chandramohan sir, and Dr. Anil sir, to giving me the opportunity here. So today I will be having a very small talk on basics of laser settings, both holmium and thulium. So RIRS is the most common procedure done worldwide, as we all know. The laser setting has one of the most crucial factor for a stone free rate. Both holmium and thulium have different laser settings totally. First, we will discuss about the holmium laser. I will not be going into the details of the machine. As we all know, it contains of the mirrors with the NDAC crystal, which is doped with the holmium ions. So before entering into the settings, what we are commonly using, I would like to know about the energy, frequency, and the duration, which I will be using again and again, which will be useful for negotiating the laser settings. So energy is nothing but the force with which you are hitting the stone. The frequency is nothing but the number of times you are hitting the stone, and pulse width is each contact of the laser fiber with the pulse with the stone. Is it a short duration of contact or it is a long duration of contact? So when we have a holmium energy, so in flexible electroscopy, we have a lowest energy is 0.2 and the highest is 2 joules. When we use a lower energy, we will have tiny fragmentation of the stone. And if you use a very high energy, there will be large fragmentations. So frequency ranges from 5 hertz to 80 hertz, even in 120 watts machine. So frequency mainly helps in reducing the number of powder, or reducing it to the more dust when number of fragments are formed. If you have a very small calyx, and if your laser fiber is at the tip of, or it is just touching the stones, then the fragmentation is much better compared to the one where the calyx is wide open and the laser fiber is far away. So pulse width, that is short pulse and long pulse. Short pulse is 150 to 350 microseconds. It breaks the stone, but there is increased retropulsion. Whereas in long pulse, that is around 500 to 1300 microseconds, it also breaks the stone, but there are less retropulsion. So Luminous came up with this MOSES technology, where they have used the two bubble effect to drag the stone towards the laser fiber to fragment it in a much better way and reducing the retropulsion rates. So we will be discussing the laser lithotripsy techniques because each technique has different laser settings. So first, coming to the painting technique here, these are best for the soft stones, and you need to just place the fiber in contact with the stone and brush back and forth, ablating layer by layer. Here the energy we use is around 0.5 joules. That's the lowest energy possible in a 30 watt holmium machine with a frequency of 10 to 15 hertz. The chipping method is nothing but the same painting technique, but we are coming from the edges of the stone. We will be fragmenting it piece by piece as small as possible. We do it most commonly for the hard stones. Here also the energy will be 0.5 joules, that is lowest, and frequency is 10 to 15 hertz. For popcorning, we need very high energy and high frequency. That is, energy is 1.5 to 1.5 is the maximum energy in a 30 watt machine, and a frequency of 15 hertz, which will make the fragmentation much efficient. Fragmentation, we commonly use it for the bladder stone, where we can extract the fragments or make into multiple small pieces and we can extract them. Energy is 1.5 to 2 joules and frequency is 5 to 8 hertz. So for popcorning settings, the best one is to the most efficient in smaller spaces. Displace the stone into a calyx before popcorning, and no difference is seen between the high power settings. What challenges with the popcorn is we can't do it in the ureter or in the renal pelvis. You have to push the stone into a calyx, and the heat generation, because of the multiple vibrations of the frequency, there is heat generation. So dusting technique, here we use a high frequency at a very low energy setting. The 0.2 to 0.5 joules and 20 to 80 hertz, and submillimeter fragments are formed. So I would suggest that there is no perfect definition of a dust, as everybody will agree. Few say it is just the tip of the laser fiber, few say which is floating, few which is less than 250 micron. But whatever is said and done, if we decide that these fragments are going to pass off without any basketing, without any relook, then we say it is completely dusted. So this can be done by a contact phase or a non-contact phase. In contact phase, we are using dancing or popping or chipping method. In non-contact, we use popcorn or golf hole effects. So whether to fragment or to dust depends on the individual surgeon experience. But as we move from a smaller to larger volume of the stone, the number of times coming out of the access seat is very difficult. It will damage the scope and also the ureter. So both dusting and fragmentation has advantages and disadvantages. So last one is the pop dusting, where we are combining the dusting method and also the popcorning method, which gives a much better result with a very short period. 120 watt machine at 0.5 joules, that is 80 hertz setting, it gives a pop dusting. So both holmium and thulium are very good for pop dusting, but in holmium we have to use a very high energy one. In our experience, as we are using in the last 1 year with the thulium fiber, since it is introduced in our India, so thulium fiber does a little bit better compared to the holmium on pop dusting. So thulium fiber laser. So just a brief introduction. This is nothing but a fiber which does not have any crystal or anything. This small fiber is around 10 to 30 meter long, which is doped with thulium ions. When the diode laser are connected, the energy is produced from this diode laser, which passes through this fiber. The exit laser fiber will develop the thulium energy fiber there. So this thulium fiber laser has a specific wavelength, which is 1940 nanometer, which is very near to the water absorption coefficient compared to the holmium. So it has better water absorption, better bubbles formation, so better fragmentation of the stones. So these are some of the examples done in our unit. So when we are using the thulium for the same painting technique, we can use the energy as low as 0.025 to 0.1 joule, which is not possible with the holmium, and frequency ranging from 80 to 300 hertz. So chipping method, same, the lower energy and high frequency is used. So the technology is same, the method of doing is same, but only the settings of the laser are different. Popcorn, I should say one of the best popcorn method. Whatever the amount of stone burden in the calyx, it will reduce to powder in no matter because of the very high frequency which you can achieve with this. So energy will be high, 0.2 joules, and the frequency is also high. So fragmentation, as I already told, just to fragment the stone and extract with the basket, this does a wonderful work. So I'll be sharing the last one where if there is an inferior calcium stone, the patient did not want PCNL. So it was around a 2 centimeter stone. We had to do it in one sitting. So we first used the holmium laser to do the dusting as much as possible, then reduce the fragment as small as possible. Then we used the thulium once the fragments were small. So within no time, we were able to achieve a very fine fragmentation and complete clearance of the case in within one sitting. So to conclude, no laser settings are universal for a desired endpoint. So 100% of stone free rate must be the aim for the laser setting. Pop dusting is currently popular for the same. Medium stone dust as much as possible. Popcorn with a very high energy laser setting is very useful in a closed system. We should always remember laser produces the heat. Thank you, sir.